Good morning, Calvary. Pastor Chad here with your word for the day. I hope you're ready for a great weekend as we celebrate Jesus and as we talk about Christmas. I hope you're ready for Christmas. It's getting close. It's only 8 days away. So this may sound weird for Christmas, but there are evil things that consume us. If we give in to them, then evil will consume our lives. This is Christmas season. There's lots of parties. One of those things that will consume you is alcohol abuse or drug abuse. Okay, and there's a lot of people who during this season use alcohol to excess, maybe because they don't like the people that are around, maybe because it's available and everybody's drinking, maybe because they're depressed and lonely and sad, and they use it to cover up. That will consume you. For some people, it's food, and food is glorious and wonderful and delicious. But if you get fixated on food and use it to mask your pain, it will consume you. Another thing that people use is this time of year, it shows itself in the Christmas season, is greed and materialism, right? Because everybody wants more, always more, got to get more, got to have this, got to buy this, got to wear these things, got to look the part, and it can just consume you. And you realize that, come January when the bills arrive. Well, there's one more thing that consumes you that I want to talk about today, and that's lust. Lust. Lust has been around since the beginning of sin. Okay? It's part of it. It's a corruption of love. And Proverbs 27:20 says this: Sheol and Abaddon are never satisfied, and never satisfied are the eyes of man. So death and hell are never full. They always want more. And that's how it is with lust. That's how it is with lust. Look, lust has been around from the very beginning of sin, and today it's prevalent and it's easy to obtain through pornography. Internet pornography is everywhere. You don't have to go to a CD bookstore anymore in a bad part of town and sneak in wearing a trench coat and a hat and all that kind of stuff. It's just available at your fingertips on every device everywhere you go. And it's consuming people's lives. It's destroying them, because the more you give in to evil desires, the more they own your soul until everything is tainted by lust. In fact, you can't see a person anymore. All you see is an object that you want to use. You can't serve people anymore because you only think about using people. In fact, the reality is you can't love anymore because you're only interested in your selfish desires. And love is never about you. It's always about caring for God and caring for others. In fact, the Apostle Paul warned Timothy, who was already in ministry, to flee youthful lust. So this is a problem that afflicts everyone. Pretty much everyone has to fight this battle of the mind, the battle of the eyes that are never satisfied. And Proverbs targets men because, Solomon writing to his sons. But truth is, over half of Christian men, self-identified Christian men, say they struggle with pornography. Truth is, about half of pastors in ministry admit that they struggle with pornography addiction. It's everywhere. And so if you really want to stop feeding the beast of pornography, if you really want to stop indulging your eyes that are never satisfied with lust, then can I encourage you to admit that you have a problem? You got to tell somebody. I mean, it's killing you in private. You got to go public with it, at least to another person who can offer you that support, that prayer, that accountability. And then can I encourage you to attend Celebrate Recovery? Because you got a problem. And it's a place for people with hurts and habits and hang-ups that are destroying their lives, and they will help you find freedom. And then can I just challenge you to install some accountability software on your devices, on all of them, which means you're going to have to tell your wife or some other person that you've got an issue with this and you want their help protecting you. Here at the staff, at the church, all the pastors on staff use Covenant Eyes. And we're accountable to each other for what we're looking at. And let me just tell you, it removes temptation when you think, do I really want to have that conversation with other people about what I've been looking at? It makes it a whole lot easier to say, no, I'm not going to look at that. I don't want to see that. I'm not going to do it. Because all of us are tempted. The question is, what are you doing to protect your eyes so that the sin of lust does not consume you, because it's never going to be satisfied. And then, after you do all that, just keep asking God to purify your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Now again, I know that's a weird subject for Christmas, but reality is it's a 365-day-a-year battle that we're facing, and you don't want to give in to, you know, Sheol and Abaddon, which are never satisfied, and you don't want to give in to the lust of your eyes. God bless. Merry Christmas. Have a great day.